Welcome to Shree Learning Academy. Our today's topic is birthday attack. So let's get started. Understanding birthday attacks in cryptography. Imagine attending a party with only 23 people. What are the odds that two people will share the same birthday? You'd be surprised to learn that the odds are around 50%. This is known as the birthday paradox, a concept that not only affects our real-world social interactions but also significantly impacts digital security through what we call birthday attacks. The birthday paradox, a mathematical oddity. The birthday paradox, or the birthday problem, is a statistical phenomenon which shows that within a group of just 23 people, the probability of two individuals sharing the same birthday is approximately 50%. This seems counterintuitive because the total number of unique birthdays is relatively large, with 366 possible days, accounting for leap years. You'd assume you'd need a group size approaching this number to have a 50% chance of a match. However, the mathematics of the situation show that's not the case. The probability of a matching birthday increases exponentially with each new individual added to the group. The paradox arises from the pairwise comparisons between individuals in a group. Within a group comprising 23 individuals, there exist a total of 253 distinct pairs that can be formed. The high number of comparisons greatly increases the chance of a shared birthday. Application of the birthday paradox in cryptography, birthday attack. Now, let's connect this seemingly odd statistical fact to cryptography. In cryptography, a birthday attack is a kind of brute force attack that exploits this birthday paradox. Just like in the birthday problem, where we have a limited number of birthdays, in cryptographic hashing, there's a finite set of possible hashed values. Despite the astronomically high number of potential hash outputs, the probabilities change drastically when we start to look at the large number of possible pairs. Brute force attacks, in general, work on the principle of making a lot of attempts to guess a password or encryption key correctly. It's like trying to guess a combination locks code by attempting every possible combination. Given enough time and resources, a brute force attack will always eventually succeed. Brute force versus birthday attack. To differentiate, a brute force attack involves trying all possible keys until the correct one is found, a process that can be resource-intensive and time-consuming. However, in a birthday attack, the attacker is not looking for one specific hash, but any pair of inputs that produce the same hash value, a hash collision. The mathematics behind the birthday paradox reveals that finding such a pair is highly likely after making approximately square root of the total number of possible hashes number of attempts. This is much more efficient than a simple brute force approach. Birthday attacks in password cracking. A common application of birthday attacks is password cracking. In a typical setup, a user's password is stored not in plain text but as a hashed value, using a cryptographic hash function. When a user enters their password, the system hashes it and compares it with the stored hash. If the hashes match, the password is correct. This system is generally secure as cryptographic hash functions are designed to be one-way functions, easy to compute in one direction, but practically impossible to reverse. However, if an attacker gets hold of the hashed password list from a data breach, for example, they can attempt to discover the original passwords. Here's where the birthday attack comes into play. Using a powerful computer, an attacker can generate millions or billions of potential passwords, hash them, and check for matches in the stolen hashed password list. The same principle as the birthday paradox applies: the more hashed passwords the attacker generates, the higher the chance that one will match a hash in the stolen list. The impact of birthday attacks. This efficient form of attack has a significant impact on the security of cryptographic systems. It means that systems must be designed to withstand attacks even from adversaries with substantial computational resources. For hashing systems, this often means using a hash function that produces a larger hash output. For instance, moving from a 128-bit hash to a 256-bit hash doesn't just double the security, it squares it. This is because the number of possible hashes doubles with each additional bit, making the task of finding collisions exponentially harder. Another protection mechanism is the use of salting in password storage. A salt is random data that is used as an additional input to a hash function. By salting a password, even common passwords end up with unique hashes, thereby reducing the efficiency of pre-computed tables of hashes, also known as rainbow tables, that an attacker might use in a birthday attack. Conclusion. In conclusion, the birthday paradox, a mathematical oddity that seems quirky in our daily lives, has profound implications for digital security. This surprising statistical fact underscores the essence of a birthday attack, an ingenious method that exploits the mathematics of probability to crack encryption keys or passwords. This type of attack exemplifies why security professionals always have to think one step ahead of potential hackers, continually innovating to keep our digital information secure. Thank you so much for watching this video. Do check out the written explanation on our website and don't forget to take this quiz based on this video. The links are in the description box below. Subscribe to our channel to watch more interesting videos. If you have any doubts, do let us know in the comment section and we will try our best to solve them for you. For private coaching, do contact us by visiting shreelearningacademy.com or on WhatsApp. See you in the next one.